Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Warm welcome to you from Emmanuel Lutheran Church here to our Lessons and Carols service. Everything you'll need for the worship today has to be in the bulletin. So everything is sung out of the bulletin for today. Our first hymn is printed for you in the bulletin. And let's join in singing, Arise, O Christian People. Father,
time is coming and has now come
when the true worshipers will worship the Father. In the name of the Son,
whose birth we celebrate, was sent to redeem us from our sin.
In the name of the Holy Spirit,
and the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all mankind together will see it.
This is how God showed his love among us.
He sent his one and only Son through him.
This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us.
And sent his Son as the atoning sacrifice for our sins.
Let this good news be our comfort, our joy, and our strength.
Fill our lives with the message of your peace and the music of your grace.
Burst into songs of joy together, you ruins of Jerusalem. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we know that you are present in this room. Prepare our hearts and our minds as we journey to the manger to witness your incarnation. Remove our fears and our doubts. Forgive our sinful thoughts and deeds that are not pleasing to you. And once again, cover us with your righteousness and your holiness as we worship your name with our worship.
Hear us, Lord, and forgive us.
The Lord does hear your prayer and has forgiven you. We continue to pray, come quickly, Lord, in your grace, in your power, and in your glory. To God be the glory.
He is doing great things.
The congregation may be seated. Our first reading, the first giving of the promise in Genesis chapter 3, beginning at verse 8. Then the man, that's Adam, and his wife, that's Eve, heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden. in the cool of the day. And they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And God said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all the livestock and all the wild animals. You will crawl on your belly, and you will eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity, that is, make an enemy of, between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will crush your head, and you will strike his heel." This is the word of the Lord. Our festival bells, what child is this? Second reading Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her hard service has been completed, that her sin has been paid for, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all of her sins. A voice of one calling in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord. Make straight in the wilderness a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain will be made low. The rough ground will become level, the rugged places a plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all mankind will see it. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. And the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. This is the word of the Lord. The choir will now sing, For unto us a child is born. Third reading But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel from ancient times. Therefore, Israel will be abandoned until the time when she who is in labor gives birth, and the rest of his brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth, and he will be their peace. This is God's word. We'll now hear from the festival bells, O come, Emmanuel. Fourth lesson from Luke chapter 1, the angel Gabriel visits Mary. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin pledged in marriage to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But she was greatly troubled by the statement and was wondering what kind of greeting this could be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, because you have found favor with God. Listen, you will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will never end." Mary said to the angel, "How will this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "See, I am the Lord's servant. May it happen to me as you have said." Then the angel left her. This is God's word. The choir will now sing, "Come, O Jesus, Holy One."
Amen.
fifth reading. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. This is God's word. We'll sing together with the choir, Silent Night. Sixth lesson. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests. This is God's Word. The festival choir will now sing Christmas Trilogy.
Thank you.
The seventh reading, the shepherds go to the manger. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. This is God's word. The choir will now sing, "Go to Him in Bethlehem."
Thank you.
Let's stand for prayer. Almighty God, Heavenly Father, we are thankful that you have fulfilled all of your ancient promises and sent us a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Your Son left the glory of heaven and became flesh of our flesh. He became our brother so that through him we might become your children. We marvel at his grace that though he was rich, yet for our sakes he became poor, so that we through his poverty might become rich. We are indeed rich, for we have peace with you and access to your throne in every need. Dear Savior, give us a simple childlike faith that sees your glory even in your lowliness. Help us all to rejoice in your birth. In sincere faith, we join the song of the angels and share in the delight of the shepherds. May the truth, love, and redemption that you have brought dwell in our heart and in our lives. Like Mary, may we keep all these things and ponder them in our hearts. And since you came for all people, help us to share this good news of great joy that we have in you. As you have shown us your glory on this holy afternoon, so one day bring us into your glory in heaven, where we will take our places among the saints and angels. There we will forever praise and glorify you for the grace and mercy that you have shown to us. Hear us, Lord, and in also your name we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, go in peace, live in harmony with one another, and serve the Lord with gladness. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with his favor and give you his peace. Amen. The congregation may be seated. The choir will now sing.
Praise to God who taught us.
It was wonderful worshiping with you this morning. Thank you very much to the bell choir and for our festival choir, for our organist, Jackie, for our choir director, Sandy, for our youth group, for getting together those cookies that I delivered to the shut-in visits the last week and a half. They really enjoyed both the cookies and also the projects that the ladies made for them. So thank you. We have some opportunities to continue to worship our God tonight at 6:30. The children are going to answer your questions about Christmas. That'll be at 6:30 tomorrow morning, our worship service at 9 a.m. Christmas Day, and New Year's Eve worship. I think time is in the bulletin. I think it's 7 o'clock. We will not have a New Year's Day service here at Emmanuel, but encourage you, if you want to go to church on Sunday, go to Christ in Denmark, their service at 11 a.m. The Lord bless your Christmas. Have a Merry Christmas. Please turn and greet your neighbor.